How do you get a 3-foot fuel tank out of a 2-foot doorway? Hi, I'm Joe with Motor City Boat Works. Last episode, we talked about removing the diesel engine from the Albin 27. After getting all the tanks out of the boat, after getting the engine out of the boat, tearing down some of the trim and all the wood, it was time to get the final fuel tank out of the vessel. Now, the Albin 27 family cruiser came in a couple of variations. One of the variations, there was one large fuel tank under the cockpit. Some of the other boats produced in the latter part of the 1980s and the early part of the 1990s used two diesel tanks on either side of the boat, also towards the aft cabin of the boat. But in this case, on my boat, I had to get out a large 3-foot by almost 3-foot fuel tank from underneath the cockpit. The only way to access this fuel tank is from the aft cabin. The first thing you do is remove the steps from the back of the aft cabin, and then you can gain access to the fuel tank, but it's a tight fit. There's lots of plumbing and scupper hoses and a variety of other pieces of equipment that are in the way, and it gotta be removed before you can actually get access to the tank. The tank itself was screwed into the decking underneath the cabin sole. In my case, the tank was not up on a platform or anything like that. And this would prove to be a problem when I later inspected the tank for any sort of damage that occurred over the years. Getting the tank out from underneath the cockpit was a real challenge. I don't know how they got it in there when they built the boat. It was entirely possible that when the boat was built, the tank was put in place first before the top of the boat was married with the hull. It seemed possible to be able to get the tank out. If I could at least pull it towards the transom into the aft cabin, then I might be able to get it out and onto the deck.
Today I'm going to remove the diesel fuel tank and get that out of the boat. It's in the back section of the cockpit here. Basically screwed into the floor, and then there's some connectings to various hoses, fill tubes and stuff like that. We'll disconnect all that and we'll pull it out the aft cabin and then get it off the boat so that it can be cleaned over the winter. And that'll open up a whole bunch of area down there to begin some work on redoing storage lockers and the engine compartment. And we'll eventually lead to redoing the fuel lines for the diesel engine.
Huh. I don't know. Doesn't seem like it wants to fit.
All right, we got it out. It was just needed a little bit of leverage to get up underneath it to get it out. That's a big fuel tank. I'm guessing it's 70-some gallons. Pretty good shape. And it's got some writing on the back side here. You can see from the original factory. Albin, Maine, 73, 1 of 10. All right.
Once the tank was out of the boat, it was time for a careful inspection. And right away, I came to realize that there might be some problems. First, the exterior of the tank, although it was generally in really good shape, well, there were noticeable signs of corrosion in a couple of places, particularly where the tank had been sitting on the deck inside the boat. When aluminum sits on top of water, especially salt water, for a number of years with dirt and grime and vibration, well, it's entirely possible that the tank can become damaged. It can suffer from chafing, and it can also suffer from crevice corrosion or even pinhole corrosion that happens in the surface of the aluminum. There were spots of pinhole corrosion, and each one of those might be a suspect location where you have to be concerned about a potential future fuel leak. I gotta say, my diesel fuel tank looked pretty good. The tank really looked to be in fairly good shape. It was robustly constructed. When it was made back in the 1980s, the aluminum plating that was used was actually pretty thick. The welds were very, very good. It seemed like this tank could be refurbished if I could just figure out a way to put in some cost-effective inspection hatches, clean out the inside, and then perhaps repair some of the pinhole corrosion. The outfittings on the tank, well, they look pretty good. However, the fuel gauge, well, that didn't appear to be working. Once I removed the fuel gauge, I was able to kind of poke around and look inside the tank. What little I could through a tiny 2-inch hole. Inside the tank did not look good. There was some kind of gunk built up inside the bottom of the tank. It didn't really slosh around. It was definitely stuck to the sides of the aluminum tank. There was going to be no way to clean this tank through the 2-inch fuel gauge hole. I did a bunch of research trying to come up with a solution. How do you gain access to the inside of a large 3x3 tank in order to scrub it clean? It turns out that they make aftermarket inspection hatches which can be installed in the top of a fuel tank or a fuel cell. They're usually made out of aluminum or some other type of metal. The problem is that they're ridiculously expensive. For the size opening that you get, well, maybe just 8 inches, well, that can cost you like $300 per hatch. And because this tank was quite large, it actually had 3 separate chambers divided by 3 separate sets of baffles. What this means is that you have to have 3 separate inspection hatches in order to be able to look inside each of the chambers separated by the baffle. And the problem is, those aftermarket inspection hatches, well, they're just too expensive. I can't imagine spending $900 for inspection hatches on a 40-year-old diesel fuel tank. I could probably purchase a brand new diesel fuel tank for the price of the inspection hatches. A lot of long-term boat cruisers and commercial fishermen, well, they have a similar problem in their diesel tanks. And what I discovered was that people made their own inspection hatches. I purchased some aluminum plating of the appropriate thickness, and I also purchased some machine screws with a tap in order to be able to tap the tank itself and also the inspection hatches. Next, I cut the 3 inspection ports. This was a little bit nerve-wracking. What is this material that's inside the tank? A lot of people like to talk about a diesel bug or an organism that lives inside your diesel tank and feeds off of the diesel itself and then produces some type of waste matter afterwards. And while such a thing does exist, it's really not the case of most of the gunk that you're going to find inside a 40-year-old diesel tank. What's inside the 40-year-old diesel tank is the leftover byproduct of diesel, petroleum products, breaking down over a number of years. It looks and smells like asphalt. It's got a granular feel to it. And if there was any doubt that it's some type of organic material or the dreaded diesel bug, well, I went ahead and I put it under my daughter's microscope so I could really see what exactly is going on. This is not organic material. This is obviously leftover petroleum byproduct. First, I was able to use kind of a spatula to scrape off most of this gunk and get it out of the tank. I probably removed a 0.5 pound to 1 pound of hard residue. I used kerosene to scrub the inside of the tank to try and get down to bare metal. Once I got all of the byproduct residue out of there and everything was spotless, well, the tank looked pretty good. The final step in this fuel tank restoration was to take it to a local shop. For about $100, they repaired the pinhole corrosion. And they even pressure tested the tank to make sure that my hatches were good. Well, what do you think? Not bad. I just want to take a moment to thank every one of our subscribers. I really appreciate it. This week, we reached 100 subscribers, only in about 50 days on YouTube. And it's really because of your support. Thank you. Please continue to spread the word about Motor City Boat Works. This week's question comes from B B. Moynihan from Hastings, Nebraska. And Miss Moynihan would like to know, what kind of water does your boat tolerate? Salt water or fresh water? Well, Miss Moynihan, my boat does not discriminate against any type of water.
If you like these videos, please hit the subscribe button. These videos would not be possible without your support.